We know that real urethane balls, like they used to produce many years ago, do not absorb oil. But do modern urethane balls absorb oil or not? And if yes, which ones? And how quickly? Great question. Let's find out. Welcome back, everyone. It's been some time since the last video, but I had a hard drive failure, so I was trying to rescue data. Most of it has been recovered, so I'm back with another test. We hear or read a lot of things on social media. Does the purple hammer absorb oil? No, it doesn't. Yes, it does. Does this ball absorb oil? Is microcell absorbing oil? What's going on? Is my bowling ball urethane? Urethane with additives. Let's sort a few things out. So, I'm testing four different urethane or urethane type balls here with proper lane oil. An old urethane from 40 plus years ago. This is the only ball that is plain urethane for sure. A hybrid urethane mix. This is Shadow Ops from 900 Global. I've been told that on this ball the black part is urethane and the silver part is pearl. I'm not entirely sure it is so, but I guess this test will tell us. A Hammer Purple Pearl Urethane. I know many people think this ball is plain urethane, but it isn't. Almost all YouTubers assume this and repeat it in their videos. It's in the name, guys, come on. It says pearl urethane. This means that if it absorbs oil, even slowly, that it may have a little bit of plasticizer in it. If not, then it means that it only has some pearl additives that allow for a stronger reaction than urethane, but has no pores. I think it's the latter, but we'll see. And the fourth is a microcell polymer ball from Motive, the Desert Tank. Now, this cover stock has a different name. I don't know if it is the same thing others use, but just a different name, or if it is something slightly different, but they gave it its own name to make a difference marketing-wise. The ball seems to have a motion different than plain urethane and more like a solid cover stock. So it's gonna be interesting to see how this type of cover stock absorbs oil. Of course, I don't have the expensive equipment that USB-C has, so I will try to emulate as close as possible their method, which was to place one drop of oil on each color of each ball and measure how much time passes until the oil is absorbed. Sounds fair? Let's do it. I don't have a precise tool to 100% be sure that each drop has exactly the same mass, so we're going to use nature's laws of physics to emulate that, meaning surface tension. So I'm fairly certain that each drop is going to be very close to exactly the same as every other drop.
So here the oil is applied. I'm trying to keep the drop straight up so it doesn't trickle. And now I will show you the full 2 hours of oil just sitting there, but let's also fast forward to light speed, or jump to the next chapter on your YouTube bar to get to the end. See you there.
Well, the test is over. That was fun. Let's summarize what we got. As you saw, the old urethane ball absorbed absolutely nothing. What was interesting was that the oil spread a lot. Even though the ball had a low grit surface, I guess there was nowhere to go. The ball has no pores and it just continued spreading. Then we had the shadow ops, the hybrid urethane, the black silver ball. There I placed two drops of oil, one on the black part and one on the silver part. And neither of them seemed to be absorbed into the boiling ball, at least from what I can tell visually. The only difference was that on the black part, the oil started to spread a little bit like in the urethane ball, while the drop on the silver part remained intact in its initial position. So maybe there is some kind of difference between the black and the silver part of the core stock. Then we had the purple hammer. The drop of oil there remained at its initial position, which is interesting as well, because that means that there is something on that cover stock beyond just plain urethane that prevented the oil drop from spreading, but also did not absorb inside. And finally, we have the microcell polymer cover stock. Now, that cover stock absorbed a little bit of oil. I can't be certain to what amount that oil was. It didn't seem like half the oil, it was much less, maybe 10-20% at most. But also interesting, that oil also spread like the old urethane. So that was kind of a mixture of all the other reactions. But also remember that I filmed this about 2 hours, so if that microcell polymer cover stock absorbs a little bit of oil in 2 hours, it's probably that from shot to shot, it doesn't even have time to absorb anything. Or it absorbs so little oil that it doesn't matter. So conclusion, all four cover stocks, all four cover stocks, did not absorb oil. And that means that during a leak, you can afford to clean them afterwards. A slight question mark about the microcell polymer cover stock, which did absorb a little bit of oil, so maybe you should clean that earlier. Now, I hear you say, I hear you say, but Dimos, maybe if the oil is not a drop and it's smeared or like a strip, it absorbs faster. And that could very well be possible. So I will redo this test, and instead of drops, I will simulate a small strip of oil, like with my finger, and we'll see if anything is different in terms of absorption rate. With these balls, I kind of doubt it, but with reactive balls, we would for sure see some difference. Maybe the microcell polymer cover stock will show some significant difference. So keep an eye out for that video. I hope you found this experiment interesting, like I did. And if you want to see more, please support the channel by liking, sharing, subscribing, and even donating with the links in the description. If you have suggestions for future experiments, write them down in the comments below. And I'll see you on the next one. Bye.